The question is, what is the budget that we get from our customers?
I'm going to remember that when I go and buy a crane. I'm going to say, my budget is this. I want that crane for this budget.
No, no. You tell me what is the budget. Okay. I tell you what is the crane. So that's okay. The deal.
Okay, so now tell me about e-mobility. I hear this is growing. Tell us more about it.
As a matter of fact, it is growing. So there's one thing for certain. It's going to come.
Okay.
Honestly, today when you look around, I mean, there's still, it seems that also the truck manufacturers, they're still looking a bit for the holy grail.
Yes.
So what is it really that we need? What is it really the customers need?
Yes.
Because it seems that because of the fact that energy is limited.
Yes.
Whereas today, I mean, by refilling diesel,
yeah,
we have unlimited resources.
Yes.
And sooner or later, as this is not happening on e-mobility, it seems that they really struggle to identify, like, where do we have to spend energy?
Yes.
And to me, it is definitely a growing business. And today you can already see in the product lines where we are more distributor related, like in the tailgates, we have also some examples here, that there's trucks or electric trucks already in use.
Yes.
And that makes a lot of sense. But if you ask me, let's say, thinking about a construction site, I think it will take time until there is really decent trucks available that will go out fully electric on the construction site, or maybe, let's say, if you do longer distance haulage. But it is going to come, it's a matter of fact, and we need to deal with it. That means that also our equipment has to be electrified sooner or later. I would call it under like a storming phase right now, yeah. And forming phase.
Yes.
And the next decade will be very, very interesting in that regard, because things will change. And I mean, looking at you, when it comes to London, I can tell that there is a moment in the very near future when government will say, like, when you're not electrified, you're not going to go in there. And again, there, and this is starting to be interesting, and for you as a customer, it will be a pain, because I tend to believe that the equipment that will be available will not be as performative as the equipment that you're using today.
Yes, that is a problem.
And that will be a toughie for you then also to start a discussion with the government and say, like, guys, you still expect me to do the job,
yeah,
for like those 5 coins, but I need to invest 3 times more in the equipment that the performance is only 80% of what I'm used to. It doesn't go together.
I tell you, that's a real pain point for us. You know, I'm looking at a lot of the equipment you have here, and I can see ways in which we can implement it, but how will that affect us cost-wise? And you know, you mentioned something earlier, it's another pain point for us, where we're going to mount this stuff on the body.
Yeah.
Like, where are we going to put this? You know, if you give me 3 or 4 large battery packs, I'm already limited with space on the chassis.
Yeah.
So where am I going? And then we're talking about the weight as well.
Yeah.
So if I'm going to a site, I want to carry a certain amount of material, but once I attach these massive batteries, you know, my weight is going down, and how much additional is this truck going to cost me?
Yeah.
So how does it, I know you've put a lot of research and development into it. Can you tell us, do you think the costs are gonna, the difference between a crane which is gonna be, you know, electrified, and a normal crane, are we talking about 20, 30% more?
The question is, what is the budget that we get from our customers? Because we can do, like, I can do all...
I'm going to remember that when I go and buy a crane. I'm going to say, my budget is this. I want that crane for this budget.
No, no. You tell me what is the budget. Okay. I tell you what is the crane. So that's the deal.
Okay.
So like, sorry, Daniel. It's, look, it's the tiny one here. No.
Yeah.
You know, as soon as we know how much we can spend, talking about, is it possible... Yeah. That an equipment could cost like extra 40-50%,
yes,
it enters new opportunities on performance. So the more we actually can use, the more money we can spend on the equipment, the better it will be.
Okay.
But if the job doesn't pay you, it doesn't matter how good our product is, because then you simply cannot afford to buy it. And this is also something that is really tough for us now, because we don't really know. And if you look at electric trucks today, I mean, they cost a fortune.
Yeah.
This is like 3 times as much as an... And of course, we know this will not continue like that. The prices will go down. But do they come down to the level where we have diesel engines today? Wow,
yeah, that would take a long time, yeah.